Hey, happy Friday, everybody. Mark again here, Weatherman Plus. Now, I'm going to give you the latest update on what's going on in the tropics because we are seeing new information this morning. Matter of fact, like I showed you yesterday, how this wave is taking a westward push and it's not going into the Atlantic like it's been previously thought by a lot of people. This has always showed a westward push. Matter of fact, this morning, we're seeing an even further westward push. Now, National Hurricane Center has gone down in their intensity. Instead of 50%, they went down to 40% because we're seeing a high pressure now. This high pressure over here that's blocking to where this can go further to the north, going right by Florida or right into the Gulf of Mexico, which I am showing all of September will be potentially into the Gulf of Mexico. I will show you. But now this high pressure is expanding out even further. And we have our big high dome of heat, which is a high pressure. So this would be pretty much a conveyor belt traveling to the west. And if that trough don't come in and break up that high pressure and allow this to go north, the high pressure from the high dome of heat will continually bring that to the west. So this will be either really, really bad or really, really good. So I'm gonna show you the latest information in this video. That way you know what to expect in the tropics. If you've never been here before, make sure you subscribe. I am all year along with my weather forecasting. And during hurricane season, I pay special attention because this literally ruins people's lives. And we're talking about for years. People are still getting past hurricanes that we had years ago. All I ask is if you know someone that this could potentially impact, please share this information on other social media platforms or just hit that like button down below. That will help other people see it on their homepage. Thank you again for your help. I will do another update this afternoon. It'll be a quick, short update. This is where we know what the latest trend is because this is some new information this morning. Now, you see the one in the back. It's still at 20%. I wouldn't worry about this. It's still curving out. This one has gone down to 40%. They even taken away the 10% in the last 48 hours. And it's such a dramatic change. And pretty much what National Hurricane Center, just like when we had Beryl and these other ones, they're doing whatever they see with the European model. So as the European changes, so does National Hurricane Center. So just like when we had Beryl and it showed the European path and National Hurricane Center stayed with that. And when the Euro came over towards what GFS seen, then National Hurricane Center changed as well. And to me, that's just a little weird just to be doing whatever a model is saying. But anyway, let me show you all the information and what could change. Now you can see from National Hurricane Center in 72 hours, we're still gonna have that high pressure going around. We still got these tropical waves bringing all this tropical moisture into the Gulf. That has not changed no matter what. But you can see where this tropical wave is going to be in 72 hours. And you can see the atmosphere. It literally would be directed into this path if it were to stay in this direction. Now, this high pressure is going to expand. And then this trough is going to come down and could potentially break that up. Now, you can see the latest information. As it travels to the west, it could either get slipped over this way because of an expanded high pressure, or it could go this way and still go around over the southeast. Now, when you follow it a little bit further, a little more information, you can see in 5 days, chance for a tropical depression to form while you still have that storm in the Gulf bringing y'all all this tropical moisture and the rainfall. Now, as you start going towards 7 days, 7 days is where it changes. You see how it's trying to still go right towards Florida, but now we're starting to get a bend to the west that could potentially grow. So as you go 8 days and 9 days, you can see it tries to go to the west because it's getting steered by high pressure. But then you can see it starts changing towards that northward path again. And now we're going 10 days and you see that little turn that it's going to eventually do as that system comes around, showing 11 days in the Gulf and staying there going around the southeast. Shown by the ensembles, in 7 days, that second wave is still going to be doing its curve into the Atlantic. But this first wave is just such a wide variety. So if it's on these fast track waves in the front, it will definitely sneak in and get in towards the Gulf. And these ones on the backside, these are where it's favoring, where it more likely will be. And these are going a little bit slower, a little bit southern, and going further towards the west. But you still can see it still steers to the north as you go towards 9 and 10 days. That's 10 days right there. And you can see where these tracks are headed. more likely is still going right into this direction. And what we're seeing this morning is a lot of strong activity. 957, 936, 935, 948. Matter of fact, the latest on GFS is very concerning. Now, after this, we have another wave passing through, and that one could go further to the west. And that is the one that a lot of these are bringing down to a 919, 950s, 940s, 920s. We're talking Cat 4 or higher strength. Very concerning. So when we take a look at the dynamics in the atmosphere and see what exactly is going on, because hurricanes don't steer themselves, the atmosphere steers them around. They have very little influence. Strengthening and weakening is about the only influence that they have on a little bit on direction. Now you can see here with GFS, we are literally past 7 days a little bit already. And you see how it's steering it to the western side of the Caribbean. You can see a high pressure here. Very weak, though, but still you can see that high pressure that is steering that to the west. Now, when you take a look at the same shot with the Euro, it's taking a high pressure a lot stronger, where it just connects almost with that big high pressure of heat and just steers everything further to the west, and that trough is not hitting it. Now, when you look with the Canadian to try and see a trend, the Canadian is showing that the high pressure is not going to be strong, and it will get steered right into the Gulf, just like we've been seeing, just a little bit westward of a track. Now, when you go with the GFS, GFS is showing a bad case scenario. After it takes that westward jog, once it gets close towards the Yucatan, then it's going to take that northern jog, because you got that trough coming in with that system that's breaking up the high pressure in the Gulf, allowing that to travel north and more to the west. And we are talking about a Cat 4 or a Cat 5 hurricane. Now, the Euro still sees that high pressure will expand out. This is something new. See how it shows it right here? But then it immediately expands out, and the trough does hit it. The trough comes in, breaks up that high pressure, and it should be heading north at this point. But the model is taking it further to the west when there's no high pressure right here. That should be traveling to the north. But still, this is the latest run with the Euro shown in the last few frames that will be traveling a little bit further, potentially to the west. This is something very new today with the Euro. But this is why it's very disturbing, because you can see how it just stays weak when we go with the GFS and start trying to see a pressure system on it. And that's always been the trend, that it's going to stay weak. That's why it's going further to the west. But look at this. The high pressure retracts back. The trough comes in and breaks it open, and it heads north, right to the western side of the Gulf of Mexico. That right there is bringing it all the way down to a very strong hurricane and getting it all the way down towards a 950 millibars. Very powerful. This right here would be worrisome just for the fact that all the warm waters in the Gulf, this would happen without any wind shear. However, we're still definitely seven days away from whether this is going to keep going west or is it actually going to turn north in that Gulf of Mexico. When you go by the control member of the Euro, it's taking a little bit further, showing it just stays so weak that it travels further to the west. And some energy goes up towards the east coast, potentially could get a quick tropical storm just forming up real fast in the northeast, while that goes potentially right into the Yucatan and go further towards the west. That's the latest on the Euro this morning. This is subject to change. This is the first time the Euro has shown this, and the other models are showing a little bit further to the north, and that this is going to turn into Gulf, agreeing with the Canadian and the GFS. And you can see the latest information on potential velocity anomaly. So we can see this right around the 10th, still showing that chance for that formation right into our Gulf of Mexico. That has not left. What is concerning is when you look at all of September and the very beginning of October, it went right back to the very beginning of October like it's been showing. Look at all this potential velocity. Now, I mean, all this energy, all this lift is right going into our Gulf of Mexico. So all of September, it looks like we're going to be battling this type of weather pattern. And we had that big anomaly just showing still August 1st. It was showing late September. You can see how it's broken up into two different storms right there. So very late September, very beginning of October is going to be a very powerful moment. plus what's going on in our storms. Can you see we do have these storms still going on for today? We still have the storms in the Gulf of Mexico, still bringing y'all all that tropical moisture. But we do get a group of storms that forms over here with the front over here by northern Indiana, all the way for Michigan. And that right there, you can't rule out a quick spin up when you get that. It could be somewhere into the line. But you see how it's just sporadic in nature, a little bit of here and there as you go through the day. And after you go through the afternoon, that's pretty much going to be it. Before tomorrow, this is going to transition across Ohio Valley and the Great Lakes and start bringing storms towards West Virginia, Virginia, Maryland, Pennsylvania, some of New Jersey, just going towards the Mid-Atlantic for tomorrow, bringing some more thunderstorms. No chances for tornadoes for tomorrow, but bringing more storms for tomorrow. And showing for today, you do have marginal and a little bit of slight risk, and that is for a little bit of a chance for a tornado. It's only 2%, but so far, here's your cities in Michigan that could potentially get a tornado for today. It'd be somewhere around 3 to 5 p.m. You also see you have your chances for your wind and your chances for your hail, and the wind's showing a little bit stronger. So here's your cities and states at risk for the possible wind threat for today. Now, as you go into tomorrow, it's going to move further over. No chances for tornadoes for tomorrow. Once again, this is going to be for chances for wind and a less chance for hail. So for tomorrow, for Saturday, here's your cities and states at risk for possible winds. And that is your latest update, everybody. I will do an afternoon update just so we know what the trend is, if this is going to continue or if it's going to flop right back. Because what the GFS is seeing is very concerning, and the Canadians agreeing in that path as well. Only the Euro right now is by itself, and it's only for one run. So tell me what you think down below. Do you think this is going to go all the way into the Eastern Pacific? Do you think this is still going into the Gulf? Or do you think it's just going to be a sham and just go away? Now, before I go, a quick praise to our Father, Psalm 95, 1 through 7. O come, let us sing unto the Lord. Let us make a joyful noise to the rock of our salvation. Let us come before his presence with thanksgiving and make a joyful noise unto him with psalms. For the Lord is a great God and a great King above all gods. In his hand are the deep places of the earth. The strength of the hills is his also. The sea is his and he made it, and his hands form the dry land. O come, let us worship and bow down. Let us kneel before the Lord our Maker, for he is our God, and we are the people of his pasture, and the sheep of his hand. Today, if ye will hear his voice. Amen. Have a great day, everybody. I'll see you this afternoon for a quick update. And once again, this could be either potentially good or potentially bad news. So let's hope on the good ones. Let's hope that this is going further to the west, just going to the Eastern Pacific. I don't like to cheer on these storms at all. We shouldn't cheer them on. This literally changes people's lives for the worse. So I'll see you this afternoon. Remember, all glory does go to God, our Father in heaven, Yahweh. And I always hope he keeps you safe every single day of your life. And forever. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Have a great day, everybody. Don't worry about the tropics. Let me do all the worrying for you. I'll see you this afternoon.